Hey folks, so I'm on a series of desk setup upgrades or overhauls, and in this video, we'll have a look at my newest gaming setup. You might think that I have a lot of desk setups, and I would sort of agree, but we just bought a new house and have quite a bit of space for hobbies and work. So this room's for gaming and for filming YouTube videos. Let's have a look. So, as usual, I went with a standing desk, but decided to go with a DIY route. So, I got this EQ3 sit-stand frame from FlexiSpot that they gladly sent over for this video, and while they do offer complete desk setups, I wanted to find a cool tabletop for this one. But let's start with assembling the frame. So, I started by unboxing it with all its parts, then I assembled the center section of the desk and added the two sections that support the tabletop depth-wise. I flipped the whole assembly and added the legs with four screws on each side, and finally the feet with four other screws. Flipped the whole thing up and then added the tabletop. I then pre-drilled some holes to secure the top in place, as well as for the controller, and then finished the assembly by adding screws in all these holes I just drilled. Alright, so this EQ3 desk frame from FlexiSpot is feature-packed. The controller is pretty good, with an OLED screen for the current height, as well as 4 preset height settings. It supports up to 275 pounds and offers a 3-stage leg design, which helps to go lower. I really appreciate that, as 2-stage design frames usually don't go low enough for a proper ergonomic position. The motors are also surprisingly quiet, while going at a decent pace.
As you can hear, the motors are fairly quiet.
I would say the biggest downside compared to more premium standing desks is the overall wobbliness. The center section is made of a single tube instead of two, and when standing, the top isn't as stiff as other higher-end desks I've tried. It's definitely manageable, and I'm putting a lot of weight to make it move here. With a normal usage, it should be alright. But still, for $330 Canadian, this is definitely a great value, and I like that you can buy the frame only and add your own tabletop for a more personalized desk. Speaking of which, for the tabletop, I went to EQ3's Liquidation Center in the Greater Montreal area. Funny enough, this furniture store had the same name as the model of the sit-stand frame. But anyway, there I found a really solid oak tabletop. It's made from actual real wood pieces glued together, and there's even metal sections to make sure it stays straight over time. So, a really high quality desktop. It does have a few imperfections, but for the $145 Canadian price I paid, I'm really happy with my purchase. Now to cable management, I decided to reuse a technique I've used in the past, which requires rack mounts that are meant to be drilled under the desk. Given that it's a solid wood top, these mounts will be super strong. I also used the included cable ties with screws to hold cables in other areas of the desk apart from the tray. And then I used a rack mount power strip to connect my PC, monitor, the desk itself, and any other accessory that requires power, and the other rack mount as a cable management accessory so that I can guide cables between the PC and the rest of the desk. It's a relatively expensive solution and requires a lot of efforts, but I like how sturdy it feels for when I want to plug or unplug cords, and cables hold very securely under the desk this way. So, for the chair, I decided to use my Steelcase Series 1 here, and I put my gesture in my main office instead. Given that I work more hours than I game, I preferred having the better chair for work. But this little Series 1 is surprisingly comfortable. I really like the weight-based tilt mechanism that is really well adjusted for me. I also have the 4-way adjustable arms, and they're pretty nice, as I like to rest my elbows there when I game. Okay, now to the centerpiece of this setup, the monitor. This is a new release from MSI, the Artemis 27-3CQR, and I'll have a full review on it in the next month, so this is more of a sneak peek. So, it boasts a 1440p resolution, which is good enough for a 27-inch panel size in my view, and its refresh rate is 165Hz, making it an amazing monitor for gaming. It's a VA panel with a pretty aggressive 1000R curve, so colors look vibrant, and it's a very immersive experience. Viewing angles are also pretty decent, even though it's not IPS. Not only that, it packs a KVM switch, making it a great option if you want to game and work with the same monitor. I also like how it looks. Its base is metal and looks very sleek in my view. It doesn't take too much room on the desk either. Finally, the stand has spring-assisted height adjustment. I do wish it would go a little higher, but it's really good for an included stand. Okay, now to the PC that's driving this monitor. It hasn't changed much over the years. I'm still using this classy PC case from iQunix, really liking its look, form factor, and overall build quality. It also offers a lot of airflow with the two fans I installed at the top and the perforated side panels. I'm still rocking an RTX 2070 Super. Even if it's older, I'm happy to have this card given that the GPU crisis hasn't stopped, and realistically, it's good enough for 1440p gaming. The rest of this PC is even older, with an 8th gen i5, 16GB of RAM, and an M.2 SSD, but they're still all good enough for my needs, so I'm definitely not upgrading for now. Now to my keyboard of choice, I went back to using my good old Tofu 60 in E-White, but this time with new keycaps. I just received this GMK Deep Navy set after waiting well over a year for it, and although the final color is not as dark as the renders, I still like the overall look. Paired with a white keyboard, I think it looks really good. I've also added a felt layer between the plate and PCB, and said plate is brass, with Husky switches from Kinetic Labs, for an overall high-pitched sound profile. It's a very stiff typing experience, and Huskies are a bit too heavy for me, but for gaming, it's more than good enough. Speaking of that desk mat, it's from Banggood. I think it's a replica of other group buy mats I've seen, but even there, I think people have copied from each other, and I would say that it's a relatively simple design. Anyway, I think it looks really clean. I sort of wish it was offered in navy to match with the keycaps, but black looks great too. The quality is excellent, the stitching is nice, the print quality is good, and it has a decent thickness too, so yeah, solid desk mat. Now to the mouse, it's the Rokat Cone Pro Air. I featured it in the past and it's a really great wireless mouse. I like its ergonomic shape, which fits my hand perfectly. I'm a palm grip kind of person and that's a shape that works well for that. It's super lightweight, the battery life is amazing, and it happens to match my E-White Tofu keyboard case well too, so yeah, solid choice. Okay, what about the headset? Resting on this headphone stand from Uppercase, this is the Sennheiser PC38X in collaboration with Drop. In the past, I didn't have a dedicated room for my gaming setup, so open back cans weren't the best as they don't block external sounds, but now that I have this quiet room, they're a joy to use. These have one of the best headset microphones out there for the money, and their sound quality is great too. They also have a lot of bass for open back cans. It's unfortunate they're only offered in yellow as they don't really match with my setup, but they're really good, so I guess that's an acceptable compromise. Okay, now to the lights that I'm using. I got a Govee Glide beam light on the wall. This lamp is typically L-shaped, but I decided to not use the included elbow connector for a straight beam of light. It's great for bias lighting or even just as additional lighting for videos, as the light it produces is well diffused. I like that you can set animations with it where the different sections of the light can display different colors at once for a very cozy vibe. It's especially nice for late night gaming sessions. This room is definitely missing some decoration, and I feel like this wall light is the first step towards adding a bit more personality to this setup. Finally, I also use an Elgato key light mounted to its arm. This one is really only used for when I'm reviewing products so that they're well lit. It alone is not enough, but it does provide a great light source, especially for top-down shots. Alright, so what do you think of this gaming setup? It's really simple and not super flashy with all the best gear, but it does give me an amazing gaming experience. From the high refresh rate monitor with a decent resolution, an older but still very capable PC, to the great sounding PC38X headset, this setup is a real pleasure to use for gaming. Alright, that's it for today. Thanks for sticking by until the end of the video. If you'd like to know more about one of the products I featured in this video, I'll make sure to include links to most, if not all of them, in the description. Okay, bye.